Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, I'm Patti, and on Mondays I make characters, and today I have a really fun one for you. I've got a little caveman. I had a lot of requests for this. I finally got around to figuring him out. If you want to know how to make this little guy, stick around. I'll show you how. Thanks for watching. I love you guys.
Okay, for this little guy, we're going to start by making his feet. I'm cutting a piece of foil that's 5 by 3 3/4 inches, and I'm just going to put 2 5/16-inch weights inside of each one of them and just fold it up. And that's going to be the base for our foot. Then I'm going to take some oven baked clay, and I'm just going to go ahead and roll it out, and I'm going to cover these feet. Now I'm going to try to make like a figure eight shape for his foot, and they are going to be kind of big. Just kind of get that foil completely sealed in there, and then we'll start shaping it into a figure eight. So you want the front part to be rounded, the center to be kind of curved in, and then the back part to be rounded as well, but not quite as much as the front part. And just take a little bit of time, just kind of getting this as smooth as you can get it. And then kind of roll the toe so that you can kind of make sure that it does get round. Then I'm going to take some little pea size pieces, and I'm just going to roll them up to make his toes. So he's going to have 3 toes each. So kind of make it into a ball and then just squish it down in there. And then you're going to do exactly the same thing for the other foot. Okay, then I'm going to take 2 dowel sticks. I'm going to go ahead and push them into each one of these just to make the mark where it goes. And I'm going to bake them in the oven for 30 minutes at 275 degrees. Next, I'm taking a piece of faux fur that has a 1.5-inch pile, and I'm going to cut it at 4 inches by 3.5 inches. And I'm going to go ahead and stitch all the way around. Now, this is the only sewing that you're going to be doing on this, but just hand stitch all the way around this rectangle. And then we're going to pull it tight in the center, and we are going to fill it with some polyfill. And then go ahead and gather that up, and then we're going to fill it up. Now, you're not going to get it all the way snug because you do want to leave a little bit of gap because we're going to come back in and put a stick in it. So pull it as tight as you can, and then we're going to put our needle back into it and then kind of stitch the back and the front part of this and leave 1 opening for a 1/4-inch dowel stick to go into it. Okay, then go ahead and thread your needle again, and we are just going to stitch at the very front part together and the back part together, leaving a little hole opening in the center for a dowel stick. Okay, next I'm taking a 4-inch pool noodle from Dollar Tree, and I'm taking some athletic underwrap that's kind of skin colored, and I'm just going to wrap the very top of this because he's going to have a little, his shirt is going to come across the front part. And you want to make sure that it is a skin color. Now, you don't have to use this exact same stuff, just anything that's like a skin tone. But I'll give you the link for this one in the description below. And you can use this again for a gnome that's in a bathing suit or anything like that. It just gives it the skin tone color. And then I'm just going to go ahead and glue right down the back. So you're going to roll it up as many times as you want, but until you don't see the noodle. Now that my feet have finished baking, I'm going to go ahead and take 2 dowel sticks, and I'm going to cut those at 4 inches in length each. And then I'm just going to cut them with my miter shears. We're going to start building the legs with these. Okay, so go ahead and sharpen them, and then we're going to take that same clay that we used for the feet to make his legs. And I'm just going to roll these in 2 1-inch balls. His legs will be pretty thick. So probably about a 1-inch ball, maybe 1 1/4 inch. You'll see when you get it onto your leg. And I'm just going to roll it out into like a little log. And we're not making his legs any longer than 2 inches. 2 inches max on him. Just kind of roll it out till you get it pretty full and shaped right. Tap the top and the bottom, and then we're going to run our dowel stick through it to hold it in. Just run it right through, and you can reshape it here in a second after you get it through because you are going to kind of squish it a little bit. But you want to go all the way down to the very bottom of that stick and then just roll it back out. And just make sure it does stay at 2 inches. Okay, then we're going to attach it to the bottom part of the foot or the top part of the foot with some bacon bond. This is an oven bake adhesive, and just go ahead and put your stick in there and then go ahead and smooth your leg so you don't have a line separating between the leg and the foot. Just kind of take your fingers and just kind of smooth it out. But spend a little bit of time on this because you do want to make sure that it does get smooth. And then after you get it smoothed out, we're going to go ahead and add some ankles to it. Okay, for the ankles, we're just going to take two little pea-sized pieces of clay, roll them up in a ball, and we're just going to attach them right to the sides for his ankles. And then just do the same thing with this, just kind of smooth it in so that it is one with the leg. And these legs don't have to be perfect. You know, he's a caricature, so, you know, for a caveman, he can have kind of pretty imperfect feet. Okay, then the top where the stick is, it's opened up a little bit. Go ahead and put a little bit of bacon bond in there too. And then go ahead and seal that up right there. And then we're going to bake them at 275 degrees for another 25 minutes. While those bake, we're going to go ahead and make the clothes. We're going to take a piece of fabric that's 9 inches by 6 inches. And I'll give you the link for this. I got this on Etsy. We are going to hem up the 9-inch side, 3/4 inch hem. And you can use any fabric you want. You can use any kind of, I just used an animal print because I thought it looked really cute for the caveman. Okay, next we're going to take our pool noodle. We're going to take each side and we're going to fold it over till it is 2 3/4 inches over on both sides. And then we're going to go ahead and glue it down. And then just double measure just to make sure that that side is the same and go ahead and glue it down as well. So he's going to have kind of an over-the-shoulder outfit. And then go ahead and hem up one side about 1/2 inch. Okay, then grab your noodle and go ahead and make sure that your seam is in the back, so that when you run it across there, just make sure that your seam is hidden. And then you're just going to overlap it and glue it together. And then we're just going to go ahead and glue the top, just overhang it, and then just glue it down. And then we're going to go ahead and glue the little gauze looking stuff too. Just make sure it's glued up to the top. Just pull it on up there and make sure that it is glued down as well. Now we're going to attach the hair. We're going to find the hole that we left open in the center here. We're going to sharpen a dowel stick and we're just going to push it right on inside that hole. And then we're going to glue it here in a minute. Just kind of take your glue gun and just squirt a little bit of glue down in there. And then we're going to glue the actual hair to the noodle itself. Go ahead and cut it a little bit short because you don't want it coming out the bottom. And then we're going to go ahead and glue it in. And we're just going to glue around the stick so that it sticks to the back of the noodle. And go ahead and put glue all the way around the top part of the noodle and glue it in. And the stick just gives it a little bit more stability. And then we're going to go ahead and pull it back and we're going to go ahead and glue right around the edge just to make sure it's glued in well. Next, I'm just going to take some jute. This is a kind of a darker color jute and I'm just going to double it up and I'm just going to wrap it around his waist a few times and tie it off in the front just to kind of give him a nice belt. And then I'm going to trim off the excess. Okay, next I'm going to take a piece of faux fur that measures 1.5 by 1.5, and then I'm just going to trim a U shape down at the bottom of it. And just clean off the excess. Next, I'm going to go ahead and fold the edge over and glue it down, just so it has a nice edge and not the cut-off edge. Just, you know, just barely fold it over. And then I'm just going to glue it right up there to the top edge of his head, where his hair is. And just make sure that you have your diagonal right. Okay, next I'm just going to take a 15 millimeter half bead and I'm just going to glue it right up to the edge of that where his hair is. So I'm going to take a dowel stick, sharpen both ends of it, and then I'm going to cut it off at 1 1/4 inches from each side. And this is what we're going to make the arms with to attach to the body. So you want to make sure it's right at 1 1/4 inches because that's pretty much all the room that you're going to have inside that noodle. Okay, to make the arms, I'm just going to take some aluminum foil and I'm going to cut two big strips off of this. And then I'm going to make sure that his arm is no longer than 2.5 inches. Now, you can make them as beefy or as slim as you want to, but on the length, it needs to be no more than 2.5 inches. And I'm just going to roll this up and I'm just double checking to make sure as I go. And I want to make sure that both arms are the same length. Okay, then I'm going to roll it out and I'm going to add a little bit extra foil to it because I do want them to be a little bit more beefy. So they ended up being probably about maybe 1/2 inch diameter by the time I got them beefed up. But just make sure that they're not longer than 2.5 inches. Next, I'm going to take the same oven baked clay, just roll it out just to cover up the foil. Just kind of roll it up in there and cut off the excess. And then you can just start smoothing it out as well, just like we did on the foot. And then you can roll it to make it a little bit more smooth. Okay, after you get it as smooth as you want, we're going to take an X-Acto knife. We're going to come down about 1/2 inch and we're going to poke a hole into the side so we can attach our dowel stick. And then you'll have to smooth it out again after you get that in there. Then we're going to use the oven bake adhesive. We're going to just stick it right down into that hole. Make sure your arms are exactly the same length. And then we're going to glue those in. And then we're going to bake these at 275 degrees. For 25 minutes. And while that's baking, I took two balls that are about 1 inch in size and I'm going to roll them out, and these are going to be for the hands. So you're just going to kind of flatten out the front a little bit to make it look like a hand, and then I'm just going to cut three little fingers in here, and then I'm just going to flatten out the back a little bit and then separate these open a little bit with an X-Acto knife. Do exactly the same thing with the other hand. We're going to make the little club. I'm just going to take some foil and roll it up. And you can make this however big or how small you want. I think my club ended up being maybe about 2.5 inches. But just kind of want to add a little bit of foil inside of it. And then you can just start rolling it up and shaping it. Just pull a picture of a club up online. And that's what I did. And then so I can just get the shape. The top part of it's going to be, you know, a lot thicker than the bottom part. And you want to be a little bit thin on the bottom part because we are going to put it in his hand. And if you feel like you get a little bit too thick, just pull some of it off and then just go ahead and smooth it on out. And then I'm going to add just a little piece more here just to make it a little bit thicker at the top. Just smooth this out. It doesn't have to be perfect, but just kind of just smooth it out. And now I'm pushing the little groove into the back part of the hand to add the club to it. And to give some texture to the club, I'm just going to take a little tool and just put some lines in it to kind of make it look a little bit more like wood. Okay, we're going to go ahead and attach the legs. Just go ahead and push them right up into that noodle on both sides and right in the center on both sides. And then we're going to pull them back out and we're going to glue them in. Now we're doing these all in stages because I'm waiting for things to oven bake. And that's why I'm kind of jumping around a little bit. As you're making yours, you'll be doing the same thing. Just make sure that they are even and they do stand up straight when you get done putting these together. Next, we're going to attach the hands to the arms. Just going to go ahead and push it straight down on there. Now, you do want to, I didn't do it on this one, but I would recommend it, putting the oven bake adhesive in it first and then smoothing the arm and the hand down over the top of it. Just kind of blend it in there real well. And I did do that with the second hand. Just add a little bit right at the top, then attach your hand, and then just go ahead and smooth it out. Now just take your time on this, but you just want to make sure that you don't have any lines, but just take your finger and just kind of smooth it out till it meets together. And then go ahead and open up the fingers back if you've kind of messed them up a little bit. And then I'm going to push down inside of here to open this up again to put the little club in his hand. And then just attaching some of the oven bake adhesive. Then I'm going to bake it for 25 minutes at 275 degrees. When they're done baking, we're going to go ahead and attach them. Just coming right up there, figure out where you want his arm to go, and just push that in. And then I'm going to take another dowel stick that has a sharpened end on it, and I'm going to poke it all the way straight through so I can get my other side in there as well. Just push it through till you can feel that side, and then go ahead and cut that side open. Okay, then just make sure that they are even on both sides, and then we're going to start gluing them in. And I'm just going to add a little E6000 glue inside the hole, and then I'm going to put hot glue onto the arm itself and the stick. And then do exactly the same thing for the other arm. Okay, and on this one, I'm actually attaching the E6000 glue to the stick itself and some hot glue and some onto the stick and into the arm. And then I'm going to just put some hot glue into the hole that I'm attaching this into. All right, there he is. I think he turned out super cute. He was so fun to create. I hope y'all really enjoyed the video. Be sure and give me a like and subscribe and ring that bell if you want to see future videos like this. Thank y'all so much for watching. I really appreciate it.